This video focuses on Bailey Yard in North Platte, Nebraska, given its own subdivision on the UP system, North Platte Subdivision, trains for miles as far as the eye can see. This being the first video in the Bailey Yard series, describes the overall yard in detail. However, you may wish to subscribe to our channel's Railfan playlist for later videos that will have much more running video on many particular areas of the yard. Bailey Yard is the largest railroad classification yard in the world. Named in honor of the former Union Pacific president, Ed H. Bailey, this massive yard covers 2,850 acres, reaching a total length of 8 miles and 2 miles wide. Just a few miles east of town, Union Pacific's brand new machine vision defect detector stands guard over all three tracks, the latest in defect detection, which we covered in another video already. Bailey Yard has 200 separate tracks totaling 400 miles, 985 switches, and 1,000 turnouts. The yard has 18 receiving tracks, 9 eastbound tracks, 201 to 209, and 9 westbound tracks, 221 to 229. In the video, a train can be seen pulling into the eastbound receiving yard. There are 16 departure tracks, 6 eastbound tracks, 301 to 306, and 10 westbound tracks, 304 to 313, handling 14,000 rail cars every 24 hours. Here we observe a westbound leaving on the back tracks, going behind the eastbound service facility. About 3,000 cars are sorted daily in the yard's eastward and westward yards, nicknamed hump yards, using a mound cresting 34 feet for eastbound trains and 20 feet for those heading west. The hump yards allow 4 cars a minute to roll gently into any of the 114 bull tracks. The eastbound bull has 64 tracks, 101 to 164, while the westbound bull has 50 tracks, number 11 to 60. Here they become part of an average 139 trains per day headed for destinations in the east, west, and Gulf Coast of America, as well as the Canadian and Mexican borders. Bull tracks are called so because the ground they sit on is actually shaped like a bull. With the tracks ending up on the incline, it prevents any of the trains from getting out of the bull tracks before they're ready to head out. A worker wearing a remote control manually pulls a handle to separate a car from a train at the top of the hump. After the cars are separated, they roll gently downhill using only gravity toward their designated bull track. When they pass a so-called retarder, the wheels are squeezed hard enough to slow them down so that they roll easily and safely onto the proper track for their eventual destination. A computer routes the cars onto the proper track. Signs are posted all about Bailey Yard, warning of the remote control locomotives. Technicians use remote controls like this one to operate the locomotives as they pass through the humps and other locations within the yard. The remotes give them all the control they would have as if they were on board the locomotive. To keep America moving, train operations and repair shops at Bailey Yard are open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The locomotive repair shop facility is made up of mechanics, electricians, and other skilled workers able to handle all locomotive issues from diesel engine overhaul to the changing of a light bulb on the 14 tracks through the building, tracks 531 to 541, and also 566 to 568. The shop encompasses the same area as three football fields, handling the repair of 750 engines per month. Often, when trains come into Bailey Yard, their rail cars are separated from the locomotives and are sent off to one of the humps to be redirected to trains heading to their eventual destination. While that happens, the locomotives are brought to the diesel yard to be serviced. Next to the locomotive repair shop on the southern edge is a large servicing area with tracks 501 to 505, making sure all locomotives are ready for service before arranging them into the outbound trains. With the sand tower to make sure the sand tanks toward the front of the engine are filled with sand, sand is the primary source of traction for locomotives anytime the wheels begin to slip. In front of each wheel, there is a nozzle that sprays on the track with compressed air. This is an automatic operation each time the wheels slip. This is also a fueling area along with pits for oil and lubing. The fueling service center processes more than 9,000 locomotives each month using technology like overhead cranes and elevated work bays to maintain fluid operations. On-site, one-spot car repair facility is equipped with one-spot tracks and repairs an average of 50 cars daily. The shop annually replaces 10,000 pairs of wheels, many identified through an in-motion defect detector using ultrasound technology to inspect the wheel. This detector was developed by Union Pacific and is the only one in the world. Some wheel repairs even take place without the rail car ever leaving the track, minimizing downtime. Light repairs take less than an hour, so cars can quickly be moved back into the trains. The shop can repair 18 to 20 cars per hour. Further east, we find the special ultrasonic wheel repair facility. The only one of its kind in the world, is designed to inspect rail car wheels for small defects that would otherwise be invisible to the naked eye. Special ultrasonic sensors inspect each wheel to determine if there are problems that need maintenance. The ultrasonic wheel defect detector uses ultrasound technology to inspect the wheels on a moving train. Each year, this system checks more than 80,000 wheel sets and helps uncover wheel defects that otherwise would have gone undetected. The robotic system scans each wheel in the coal car fleet every 60 to 90 days to eliminate derailments caused by broken wheels. Just under Buffalo Bill Road to the east, there is also the van yard, tracks 201 to 212, where several intermodal trains swap blocks. Many locomotives heading eastbound come in on run-through tracks 901 to 908 and are sent through the east run-through facility service track where they are loaded up with, among other things, sand, refuel for the engines, going through over 18 million gallons of diesel fuel each month and top off the fluids and clean when necessary. Locomotive crews are changed out at this location as well. In an average day, 300 locomotives are serviced and sent on their way. Here we see an eastbound run-through headed straight into the yard. The westbound service facility is much smaller than the eastbound counterpart serving the north side. Westbound run-through traffic's 276 and 293 for primarily unit trains such as intermodal, coal, and grain shipments, which do not need any attention from the yard switching activities. Here we have this westbound train leaving the yard on its westward venture. Bailey Yard headquarters houses the yard superintendent and staff who manage the yard. Also working in this building are terminal train dispatchers, managers, locomotive managers, and train crews. From this building, every one of the 985 switches in the yard can be controlled remotely. Even more amazing is that many of the locomotives moving cars around the yard are also under remote control. Thanks for watching this presentation, and don't forget to like this video, please leave your comments, and subscribe to the channel for more videos coming to our Rail Fan playlist. Please consider sharing with your friends. Chugging along.